I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. Shannon,
tell me.
How you feeling today, champ?
I feel great, champ. First day of training in California. I feel great.
And you really trained, no breaks.
You see the shirt, huh? Let's go, champ.
Representing.
That's right. That's where I'm at right now. Anybody want to spar? Anything. I'm in California right now. If you want to spar, call my man right here and come spar.
Come see you.
That's right. No, come see you. They got to go through you.
And then I'll weed them out.
Anybody. So let them all come. I'm in California right now.
But,
you want to
spar? Champ, we're going to have them sign a waiver because it may not end pretty.
Anybody. I don't care if you pro, whatever you want to spar. Hey, my man in the gym. Let's go.
What do you think of Dana White offering? Did you hear about this?
Yeah, I heard
offering about Anthony Joshua $500 million to sign him.
I don't believe it. I think it was like $350. But I don't even think that's true. I think there's a lot of hype behind that. But it'd be dope if that could happen. I would love for that to happen. Dana's a great guy. UFC's great. Dana's always loved boxing. I've been knowing Dana a long time. And he's always loved boxing. So this is no big surprise. But that's a great guy to go after Joshua. So, if he can win this week, that's a great deal.
Okay, so if he signs Joshua, and Joshua is the UFC boxer, and they offer you to fight him, I know you guys are friends. Do you take it?
Yes, brother. Yes, bro. Let's go, champ.
And what happens in that fight, you and Joshua?
Oh, it's going to be a great fight. A young lion versus the old lion. You feel me? But it's all good. I wish you nothing but the best. And good luck against Parker this week. Parker ain't no joke, champ. I'm going to keep it real with y'all. Don't be surprised, man. Parker nice with it too, man. For real, he's a good fighter, champ.
If Parker wins, is it a bigger upset than Buster Douglas, Mike Tyson?
Or no, hell no.
Much closer?
Nowhere near close because, you know, Anthony's a new guy. He's a young guy. He's got a lot to prove as far as he's only got, 17, 18 fights?
19
fights. I mean, come on. 19 knockouts. Yeah, he's got a lot of time in front of him. He's got a lot of time. I mean, come on. Think about it. He's got a lot of time to just, you know, do his thing and then make a nice living and get out of boxing. That's the way out.
You have 60 wins.
Yes, bro.
56 knockouts. How did you get so many knockouts?
I'm going fast and hard.
Now, you fought the better Klitschko, Vitaly, one that nobody wanted to fight.
Yes.
And it went all 12.
Yes.
What would you do different if you had a rematch a month later?
My arm popped in the first round, to be honest with you. This happened in the first round. You see that? And it came through that side.
It happened to Cotto against Saddam Ali. Yeah. It happened to Buddy McGregor. It happened to James Toney.
Yeah, in the first round. You feel me? So look at that.
You went the whole fight with a torn bicep.
Yes, bro. Yes, bro.
You know what? I mean, I can tell people how much pain that is.
Yeah, it was horrific, champ. But at the same time, you know, it was my shot, and I felt like, you know, it was now or never. I was in front of the great fans in Germany. You know what I'm saying? It was electrifying. So it was very disappointing for me, man. I went into a deep depression after that, man, because of the loss. I didn't get paid for the fight. You know what I'm saying? I didn't get paid for the fight. Shelly Fink, who fucked me. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Sorry to hear that.
Let's go, champ. That's why I don't like him.
That's terrible. That's really not good. It's very bad. But you grew up in New York, in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Brownsville?
Brownsville, Brooklyn. I grew up in Brownsville.
At some point,
I'm from Brownsville. I'm from Brownsville.
You were homeless at some point.
It's a different part of Brooklyn.
How did you turn that around from being homeless, from having asthma, to being a boxing star and one of the biggest people in boxing that everybody knows?
Thank you, champ. You know, hunger, determination, being told no, being, you know, disrespected by people, not being let in, you know, sleeping in the streets, you know, the hardship, the hurt, that's what made me who I am. That's what the drive is about. I use that pain and turn it into fuel. And at any given time, I can turn it back on and start going, let's go, champ. Let's go, champ.
Streets of New York are cold.
Yes, brother.
It's dirty.
Dirty.
People are vicious, too. Just regular
worse
people.
In the 70s and 80s, worse.
Oh, I can imagine. When did you get your break that you turned it around? What point? Because you could have given up.
Yes.
You could have gone another route and been in another place this time.
True, true. What kept me going? My mom, you know, I'm a single parent. My mom raised me alone, you know what I'm saying? In Brooklyn in the 70s and 80s, it was rough. And for her, my love for my mom, my desire for her was like, you know, I gotta help my mom. If you don't love your mother, what else you got, man? You feel me? What else you got in life? You know what I'm saying? So I did it for my mom and to better myself because being down was just no way for me, champ. It was no way.
By the way, what do you think of Mikey Garcia?
Great fighter. I mean, he's very, you know, he keeps it simple. You know what I mean? Does a lot, but he does it just enough. Not just enough. He's basic, but he's effective. He's right on point.
How come the TV networks like HBO and Showtime have not called you to do commentating?
I
think you do great. You actually watch boxing. You know the fighters.
Thanks,
you were a fighter. You are a fighter.
Yes, brother.
Would you do that if they called you?
Nah, I ain't into too much of the commentating, champ. I'm kind of raw with mine.
You would keep it real.
Real. Lampley and what's his name? Another boy, Merchant. They don't like it like that. I keep it a little bit too raw. You feel me? Let's go, champ.
Yeah, but they can't do their job forever.
Yeah.
So you have Wilder, he's waiting. Joshua Parker, probably Joshua wins, but I hope it's a great fight.
Right.
What happens with someone like David Price against Povetkin? What about
fighting?
That? They're supposed to be fighting, yeah.
For what? Povetkin can't fight?
How about David Price?
Povetkin a bum. I'm going to keep it real with y'all. Povetkin is terrible.
Why?
Because he's terrible. He like this small. He like this small. Come on, champ. Stop. Let's go, champ.
Okay, you say next question.
Yeah.
David Haye, if you had a chance to...
Come on, champ. Why are we talking? David Haye is not a professional boxer.
What is he?
He's a professional actor. Okay? That's what he's a professional actor. He's not a boxer. He don't really want to fight nobody.
He doesn't want to fight.
He don't want to fight nobody. He want to get his money. Now he promoting what's the boy, Joe Joyce. And that's great, man. Joe Joyce is a great fighter.
Good kid,
good coming guy. I mean, look at him. He's like, he's taller than me. He can build you a backflip. You feel me? Great personality. I wanted to sign him, by the way. I was working on something, trying to get a deal for him, but he wound up going with
Ringstar and
Stupid David. You know what I'm saying? With Corny David. And I'm happy for him, man. Hopefully David can, you know, move well and do a great job for him over in the UK. But David's a coward, so you got to be careful, Joe. Because David's a sucker and he's a coward and a dirty businessman. Trust me, champ. Dirty businessman. And I slap you in your face, David.
Okay.
If you ever come up to me and say anything out of pocket, that's for my mother. Let's go, champ.
Shannon Briggs, give me the three.
Pardon me, I apologize.
The three best.
You can edit that out if you want.
Yeah.
But now you don't have to. You can leave. No, leave my shit in. All of it. Keep my. All of it. Let's go, champ.
Give me the three best heavyweights today and the three worst heavyweights today.
The three best heavyweights today. You'd have to say. Of course, Joshua, of course, Wilder, and Parker. Yeah, champ, don't sleep. This is a big fight coming up Sunday, or Saturday, pardon me. Big fight, champ. Parker, nice, man. I hold him in high regards, man.
The three worst ones, do you think?
The three worst, I can't say that, champ. I really like the disrespect guy.
Okay, the three guys you think you would fight, 1, 2, 3, line them up.
All of them, champ.
Before anybody
can get it with the champ. You see what happened to your boy Lucas Brown. I'm glad he okay and all that. They made a big fuss. I'm happy he okay. I don't want nobody ever to hurt. I love all my fellow boxers. It's a boxing brotherhood. But you know what I'm saying? I would have touched them up, champ. Real talk. You know what I'm saying? I was supposed to fight them. I would have touched them up. I love them, don't get me wrong, but I would have touched them up. You know what I mean? I was keeping it real. Touch up paint.
What makes
a little touch up paint.
Heavyweight division, we all know one punch could change a fight.
Uh-huh.
Who's the most dangerous right now? Is it yourself? Is it Wilder? Is it Joshua?
I mean, you know, Wilder's one of the most dangerous heavyweights as far as active guys. You know what I'm saying? With me, it's just raw. I'm going to give it everything I got. You feel what I'm saying? You see when I fought Lennox Lewis when I was a kid, when I was older, I fought Vitaly Klitschko. It was the same thing. Mercer, George Foreman, Francois Walter. Every time out, I'm going to give you my best. You feel? I'm going to put it on the line. And that's what a lot of these promoters and these lot of managers don't really want to, you know, risk with me. They're like, yo, he's going to put it on the line, and we ain't really got time for all that shit. Because if we win, okay, you beat a 46,000-year-old man. But if we lose, you got knocked out by the champ. Look at him. Let's go, champ.
You're a two-time champion.
Yes, bro.
Being the heavyweight champion of the world, they say, is the most prestigious honor in sports.
Yeah.
What was it like for you when you were champ? How did your life look? Did you have more friends and more cousins than you ever had?
Nah, it was cool. It was great. It was a phenomenal time. I'm still the champ. You feel me?
Once the champ, always the
champ. You feel me? Once the champ, always the champ. But you know what I mean? We all champs, to be honest with you. It's just about bringing the champ without. But it was cool. It was just a moment in time where, you know, life was just moving fast. I was young. I was 25 years old. I won it again. I was 35 years old. And I'm going to do it again. You feel me? I'm going to do it again at 46
years. You know what? Foreman did it.
It's possible.
Right. Heavyweight is different than the other weight class. But I have to ask you this. Deontay Wilder said he would beat Mike Tyson. Lennox Lewis did not agree. I told Wilder, I think you would have a chance. What do you think?
You told him that?
I think so.
Mike Tyson? All right, stop, champ.
You know, how did Buster Douglas beat him?
You talking about Buster Douglas, you talking about, you know, Wilder's two different people. Buster Douglas could fight, let's just say that.
Right, first. Wilder's better than Buster Douglas.
You think that? What make you
39 and 0, 40-0, 39 knockouts.
Are you crazy? Champ, there's no way in the world Wilder's better than Buster Douglas. Buster Douglas was a great fighter, champ. Don't sleep on him, for real. You got to do your homework. He forced me. We had some fights where he took a couple L's, but that I did too. That don't mean nothing.
Everybody, Ali, Sugar Ray, Robinson, Leonard.
Who showed up certain times. He showed up that night. You feel what I'm saying? He showed up that night. And that's the real Buster.
So what happens if Deontay Wilder
shows up?
Wilder against Tyson.
Tyson, champ, he weighed 213 pounds. Wilder weighed 213. Mike Tyson's a vicious animal. You feel me? A vicious animal. He would have ran him down and, okay, and went to town.
Floyd Mayweather, Sugar Ray Leonard. I have the same arguments with people.
Nah, Ray Leonard, champ. No disrespect, but fuck that. Ray Leonard was the man. Look at the left hook. Look at the left hook. He fought Tommy Hearns. Tommy Hearns, champ.
Just his fist is in the size of my face.
Yeah, let's go, champ. You know what I'm saying? He fought Marvin.
Duran.
He fought Duran. It's so many. We can go on.
Okay. A couple more and I'm done here. We're talking to Shannon Briggs. Tell people where to follow you, first of all, on Instagram.
Oh, you know, it's the champ, Shannon and Cannon. Follow me on Instagram.
Shannon.
Cannon underscore Briggs. And letsgochamp.com and Twitter, all that shit.
Mayweather said in an interview just this week that he is the face of MMA and that he's 50-50 chance that he steps in that MMA cage this year.
Wow.
How do you think? I mean, you have experience at K-1.
Yes,
it's a different world. Like you said, fighting barefoot,
yes,
kicks. How will Mayweather adapt? He's now 41, and he's never fought MMA.
I don't know, champion. I ain't sure what he's doing with it, but I will say this. If Conor grab him, you feel what I'm saying, it's going to be ugly. But if he just did that shit, if he get it right in there, if he sneak it in there with them little gloves, I don't know how they let him fight with them little gloves. But if he sneak it in there right,
there you have it. Stay
Let's
tuned.
Go, champ.
Big inspiration to everybody. Let's
Thank
go, champ.
Brother.
Applies to everything, not only to boxing, applies
champs
to life.
You don't got to be no athlete. You don't got to be none of that. You're a champ. You feel me? It's with fit. If you're a champ, say, let's go, champ.
There you have
let's
it.
Let's go, champ.
Wherever you go around the world, how do people respond when they see you?
They get surprised. They laugh. Oh, shit, it's the champ.
Let's
always
go.
Said it with
you
a baseball. Yeah, it's always funny, it's funny, it's funny. I love it. It's
cool. I've heard it in Lomachenko's camp.
Yes.
I've heard it grown. Everywhere I go, people yell at it.
Let's
you started a phenomenon.
Yeah, thank you.
Did you know it was going to be this big when you started the Let's Go Champ campaign?
Man, I just kind of really needed it for myself as far as to motivate myself, you know what I'm saying? No entourage, no, just the champ, just me to myself. Let's go, champ, you know what I'm saying? So I trademarked it, and you know what I mean? It's doing well. Thank
Hopefully,
you.
I want to see it in commercials and movies,
yeah,
and everything.
They're using my shit, too, and they ain't even banned me yet, but the lawsuit is coming soon.
Hey, you got to handle it.
Let's go, champ.
All right, there you have it. We'll see what happens. Joseph Parker, Anthony Joshua, we'll see what happens. If the Wilder fight probably doesn't happen for a year or two, correct?
We fight.
Wilder, Joshua, not till a year or two from now?
I wouldn't say that long, but I say if not the end of this year, possibly.
But by the way, the Canelo situation is really out of control.
Wow.
He failed the drug test February 17th.
Yes.
They waited 18 days to give him a month suspension. For 1 month, you can't really promote the fight.
Right.
April 10th, they're going to decide if he can fight or not.
Right.
It's about May 5th fight.
Right.
That really puts the brakes on the promotion.
Well, I think people are going to go. Boxing people are going to go because they know about it. You know, boxing, you know, if you look at our fan base, it's our fan base. We all know what's going on. When you had a fight like McGregor and Mayweather, you had another audience, which was great for boxing. And it was just great. But I think that it'll be enough time to promote it. These two guys, you know, both big names in boxing.
Yeah, it's going to sell. But it's just, boxing is the what is it, theater of the unexpected. We never know what's going to happen from one day to another.
They suspended him. He's still fighting, right? He's still fighting?
He's still training a bit.
He's still fighting? No, the fight's still gonna happen?
Well, it's a question mark, but it will happen. Come on, we all know the commission already decided yes, and but they have to say, they have to say face.
And when it was me, it was like, hell no. You feel me? But, you know, money talks, man. Let's
it's
go,
a shame.
And I ain't ashamed. It is what it is. You feel me? But I knew that coming back, my whole career, I've been, you know what I'm saying, under the gun as far as, like, you know, the promoters and managers, not really.
From day one.
Day one, champ. It's the champ. I've been on my own doing it, pushing it. And I'll say, you know what I mean? If you got the people behind you with the cash, you're going to go. If you don't, you might not go, champ.
It's funny. I say that about every sport. You could be the most talented athlete in your sport.
Yeah.
But if you don't have the right people behind you, you're not going to go as far as someone who's not as talented,
sure,
not as good, but they have the right people.
That's right.
There you have it. Jengu's right here. How do you like LA compared to Miami?
Where
are you? Are
you in Miami? I live in Miami. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. I'm from Brownsville. Excuse me, pardon me. I'm from Brownsville. But, you know, I live in Miami. I've been living in Miami back and forth for the last 20 years. And now I'm moving out here. I'm looking for a house, hopefully in Newport.
Hopefully. It's a great area.
Yeah, thanks, Sean.
Best heavyweight fight you've ever seen. Which is number one on your list?
Best heavyweight fighter?
Yeah. No, fight.
Best heavyweight fight. I have to say Ali, right? Something with Ali involved.
Ali Frazier, Ali.
Let's go, champ. Let's go, champ.
Have you ever met him, Jerry?
Ali? Of course.
I don't know. That's like,
that's the chair. I remember when I was 20 years old for the first time. He grabbed my hair. I had locks at the time, dreadlocks. Uh-huh. He grabbed my hair. He said, if I fought you, I would have called you pretty lady. I said, oh, shit. He would have won, too, because I'd have been so stressed out. I'd have been trying to gun him down. And that's what he was great at, getting you off your game, psyching you out. You feel me?
But you have the gift of gab. Did he know that you were a good speaker, or did that?
Nah, we actually, he came to see me fight before. Actually, I fought in Lewiston, Maine, and it was his anniversary, and he was right there in the crowd. And after the fight, I went to his I went to his hotel room and spoke to him briefly. But he was just,
legend.
He's still here. Look at him. He's around here right now.
That right?
The champ, I can feel him.
If you had to fight him, how would you fight him?
The greatest? Pay homage, say champ, that's it.
That's it.
Let's go, champ.
Okay, is there anyone in your career that you didn't fight besides Vladimir Klitschko that you really wanted that didn't happen?
Not really, champ. I really, you know, I made the most out of my career. I was born with asthma, less than 2 pounds at birth. You know what I'm saying? For me to be in boxing, you know, only child. I was the only child growing up, no brothers and sisters, single parents. So for me to have done what I've done, it's amazing. I appreciate every moment of it.
That's amazing. Well, keep it up.
Thank you, Chad.
Stay tuned.
Let's go, Chad.
Shannon Briggs taking over every day. Stay tuned. Please report. I'm coming back recording. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.